Hello friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. In this video we will be seeing regarding torsionally equivalent shaft. Before going into the concept, we will be just have a glance of two diagrams. That is, first diagram will be representing shaft of varying diameter and second diagram will be representing torsionally equivalent shaft. In first diagram we will be having a variable diameter with a different lengths, and the shaft will be fixed, both the end of the shaft will be having two rotors which will be rotating in opposite direction. That is, one rotor will be rotating in clockwise and another rotor will be rotating in anti-clockwise. So what we're going to do is, we're just going to convert the variable shaft diameter into torsionally equivalent shaft with a uniform diameter. This is the prime purpose of our intention of this video. So just have a look at this. Actually, there will be a variable diameter with different length. Now what we're going to do, we're just going to replace it with a equivalent shaft of uniform diameter. For that, we will be following two conditions. The first condition is just converting or replacing the varying shaft diameter with the equivalent shaft of uniform diameter D and length L. And second condition is, actually just have a look at this. So for example, if this shaft is having an angle of twist theta 1 and second shaft will be angle of twist theta 2 and third shaft will be having an angle of twist theta 3. So when we sum all the angle of twist, it should be equal to the angle of twist of the equivalent shaft which we determined, which we got. So this theta will be representing the angle of twist for torsionally equivalent shaft. The summation of all these three angle of twist will be representing the angle of twist of varying diameter, shaft of varying diameter. So these two shafts should have equal angle of twist. So second condition is, these two shafts must have the same total angle of twist when equal opposing torque are applied at their opposite end. So just now we saw it with the help of a diagram. So just have a look at this. We will be having the final formula, that is, the length of the torsionally equivalent shaft will be equal to L1 plus L2 D1 by D2 whole power 4 plus L3 D1 by D3 whole power 4. Now we will be seeing how we got this formula. Just have a look at this. Now we are having a varying diameter shaft. There are totally four shafts with varying diameter with four different length. Now what we done is, we just found the angle of twist. That is, the angle of twist for equivalent torsionally equivalent shaft should be equal to summation of the all the four shaft, summation of all the angle of twist. So this formula we got from the torque equation, that is, T by J is equal to C theta by L is equal to tau by R. T will be representing the torque transmitter, unit will be Newton meter. J is the polar moment of inertia, unit will be meter per 4. C is the modulus of rigidity, its unit is Newton per meter square. Theta is the angle of twist, unit is radian. L will be the length of the shaft, unit will be in meter. Now what we're going to do, we just will be keeping this theta angle of twist on one side and take everything to the other side. So we'll be having theta is equal to L will be going upside and theta C will be coming downwards. So theta is equal to TL by CJ. So from this formula, we must understand one concept, that the torque transmitted in both the shaft will be same. So what we're going to do, we're just going to neglect torque, as well as the modulus of rigidity value will also be same for the both the shaft. So what we're going to do, we're going to eliminate the torque and C value. So finally we'll be having theta is equal to L by J. So that's what we have written here, LE divided by JE. LE means length of the equivalent shaft, JE means polar moment of inertia of equivalent shaft, is equal to L1 by J1 plus L2 by J2 plus L3 by J3 plus L4 by J4. These will be representing the individual shaft, actually the summation of individual shaft. Total of summation of angle of twist only we just write like this. So now next what we're going to do is, we know that polar moment of inertia formula will be pi by 32 into d power 4. So now just we're going to replace the je, that is polar moment of inertia, with the formula pi by 32 into de power 4, same way pi by 32 into d1 power 4, pi by 32 into d2 power 4. So in all these cases, take pi by 32 outside, and here also in left hand side we are having on pi by 32. So just cancel the pi by 32 and pi by 32. So finally we'll be having, like, after substituting formula, we'll be getting like length of LE by JE power 4 plus L1 by D1 power 4 plus L2 by D2 power 4 plus L3 by D3 power 4 plus L4 by D4 power 4. This DE power 4 is the diameter of the equivalent shaft. After cancelling, we have just cancelled the pi by 32 alone. So after that, what we're going to do? We're just going to cross manipulate this diameter of the equivalent shaft to the other side. So take this DE power 4 to the other side and multiply throughout. So LE is equal to L1 DE power 4 by D1 power 4 plus L2 D2 power 4 by D2, L2 DE power 4 by D2 power 4 plus L3 DE power 4 by D3 power 4 plus L4 DE power 4 by D4 power 4. So what we have done is we just cross multiply it, and now what we're going to do, we're just going to replace the equivalent shaft diameter with diameter 1. We can take any diameter. In this case, I have taken the diameter of the shaft 1. So when we replace, means D1 power 4 and D1 power 4 get cancelled. So we'll be having only L1 here. So same way, when you replace DE with D1, D1 power 4 by D2 power 4, we can write as D1 by D2 whole power 4. So similarly, D1 by D3 whole power 4, D1 by D4 whole power 4. Now we got the formula for the length of the torsionally equivalent shaft. So L is equal to, this is the formula. This is what we got here also. So final formula is here. I think so it's very much clear for you guys. In case if you have any doubt, mean just type in the comment section. Now we'll just see a sample problem. So in this problem, what they gave a stepped shaft with diameter 150 mm, 200 mm, 160 mm, 210 mm. So four different diameter and four different length, 300, 250, 400, 150. Four different diameter, four different length respectively. If the diameter of the torsionally equivalent shaft is 175 mm, find the length of the shaft. Now we just want to know the length of the equivalent shaft. Just write all the four respective diameter and convert it into meter, as well as write all the four length which is given in the question, and after converting we'll be getting like this. Also write the diameter of the torsional equivalent shaft and convert it into meter. Now we know the formula, LE we already got right. We know the formula here. We're just going to cross multiply this DE power 4 into the other side. So just keep it in the outside as a common. Now we know all the value of length and we know all the value of diameter. Also we all know the value of the diameter of the equivalent shaft also. So just substitute all the values and finally we will be getting as length of the torsional equivalent shaft as 1.35 meter. So this is a just sample problem. So in case if you are having doubt, mean just type in the comment section. Please do subscribe to my channel Mechanical Motivator and press the bell icon. Then only you will be getting all the videos which I upload. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.